time to pass, but not in sorrow's embrace. As we bid adieu, let joy leave its trace. The moments we shared, a treasure untold in the tapestry of life, vibrant and bold.
Each step forward, a dance with destiny. Farewell, a bridge to a new legacy. With laughter as our guide and memories to borrow. Cheers to the journey, no room for sorrow.
Good evening, respected headmaster, deputy headmaster, teachers, and my fellow Laurentians. And of course, a very special welcome to the outgoing batch of 2024.
Emotions are undoubtedly running high as we gather here today for the farewell assembly of the batch of 24.
You are now standing on a precipice of a significant transition, bidding farewell to a chapter of your lives that has been marked by growth, learning, and unforgettable moments.
So, Gopika, what do you think is the one thing that makes the batch of 24 special?
That they are extraordinary at almost everything they do?
Absolutely. We would now like to share with you an incident that occurred a few days ago.
So, we were going through the farewell video for the batch of 2023. And that's when we realized that it is nearly impossible to live up to the legacy, the masterpiece created by Priya and Nantupa. Their coordination, stage presence, and the way they owned the stage, it was all just mesmerizing.
And this is just one of the examples. Your batch is the best at sports and almost all other activities. Therefore, to live up to the legacy, the benchmark set by you, the batch of 24 is indeed a Herculean task.
So this is an occasion to bid farewell and to reminisce all those memories, the memories which we all grew up with, all those memories that you spent.
Wait. It's we spent making in the corridors, hallways, the lawns, and the many, many other memories we will cherish forever and ever.
As custom demands, we always begin with the head girl's speech.
She is a presence to behold. And when she performs her dance piece, it is a mesmerizing blend of grace and energy. She is shy, but don't be fooled. For her willpower to never give in does not shy away at defeat.
She taught us to be brave and kind, encouraged us even in our darkest of times, always by her side to guide us towards light, taught us that with a mind so strong and a will to succeed, you will achieve your heart's dream.
So without further ado, we invite our head girl, Dia Jaiswal, onto the stage.
A very good evening to the respected headmaster, deputy headmaster, teachers, and fellow Laurentians. It is said that each choice that we make engraves a path for us, ultimately leading us to a certain destination. And making these choices is not easy. It comes along with a lot of what-ifs and anticipation. When I stand here and think of the toughest decisions that my parents and I took, I am reminded of Robert Frost. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by. I realize now that the decision to come to a boarding school has made a difference in my life and made me what I am today. Having said that, I would like to thank my family and all the decisions that they have made that helped me reach where I am today, right now, at this very moment. The first time I spoke in the senior school large hall was when I was in the seventh grade. I had a very insignificant role to play back then, but I remember loving the attention and the way the large hall looked from above here. People say that time flies, and this is probably the last time I will be standing behind this podium, the last time I feel the heat of these lights, and the last time I hear my voice echoed through these walls. All of us sitting in this room have had people who believed in us, people who tried to answer questions that had no answers, told us the truth even when it was hard to hear, and told us that we could do it even when there was absolutely no proof to that. To all of those people, no number of words is enough to express the amount of gratitude that I feel. Hold on to the memories, they will hold on to you. It's hard not to get nostalgic when I think of this whole situation. I was 9 years old when I left my home and family, everything that I had ever known. And now I'm 17 years old, and I once again feel every ounce of emotion that I felt all those years ago. I grew up here on this beautiful campus and I learned a lot of things. But what I find the most important is something which is often deemed as unfortunate or sad. All the times when you have been denied and all the times when you have tried but failed tell you that life is never going to be like how you plan it in your head. And this is probably why it might seem sad. But what you and I often fail to look at and realize is that there is always something better waiting. That's the weird thing about this universe. You ask for one thing, but you get something else, which more often than not gives you more happiness than what you wished for yourself. However, going back to what I said at the very start, it's your decisions and choices. So are you going to make the most use of what you have been given, or are you going to let the what-ifs haunt you? What if this is the last time that I stand here? And what if you don't fail this time? What if it gets better? And what if someone tells you that in a few months, your life will completely change, and the people that are now a constant part of your day will soon become just faces you see on your phone screen? This morning, I wore my prefect suit for the last time, and as I put on each piece of clothing, I couldn't help but think back. Throughout this year, I would constantly remind myself that some of the things that I would do were things I would be doing for the last time. But what I fail to understand now is the heavy feeling in my heart and the choking nostalgia that I feel. No amount of preparation is enough to say goodbye to a place like Lovedale and the people in Lovedale. To the headmaster, deputy headmaster, SG ma'am, SNG ma'am, and Preslin ma'am, you have helped me become the person I am today. My mother left me in this institution knowing very little of how it would transform me, and your guidance and support helped me achieve things that I once believed were impossible. But allow me to make a small request. When you see me next, whether that's in a year or 10, I hope the headmaster still gives me a fist bump and asks me if all's well. I hope the deputy headmaster still calls me his daughter. I hope SNG ma'am still advises me. I hope SG ma'am still updates me with all her travel adventures. And I hope Preslin ma'am still silly dances with me after every dinner. I would also like to express my heartfelt gratitude to all the academic staff, the deans, the hospital staff, and the entire support staff community for all the help and guidance that I have received, without which my journey in Lovedale would be incomplete. To my friends, where do I begin and where do I end? All of you have seen me during my worst and best and have been with me through the good and bad. Not living with you and seeing you every single day will be extremely hard. For 9 years, I lived in the comfort of knowing that after every vacation, I would come back to school and I would get to spend the next few months together, and this cycle would go on. But now, how do I tell myself that these are the last few months we have together, where we can go on a walk after every meal, analyze pointless information, and stay up for long hours and still not get any work done? I don't think there has been one day where I have not laughed, and this is because of you. You make me so happy, and I have no idea what I did to deserve it. There are so many words, and yet not one compares to how grateful I am to each and every one of you. People pass through our lives. Some of them fade into memories, but a few become a part of who we are. As I near the end of this journey and brace myself for the goodbye, I would like to say that this place and the memories that resonate with it are something I could never forget. And to every single person who made this possible, I am forever indebted to you. Though our paths might diverge, the memories we have shared will forever bind us. As we embark on our new journeys with gratitude in our hearts and hope in our souls, let our spirits soar as we embrace new challenges and opportunities on our journey ahead. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Diya, for those beautiful words. And thank you for sharing all those sweet memories with us. Your story is an inspiration for all of us. And thank you again for being there for us always.
So now, ladies and gentlemen, brace yourself for the remarkable journey of a young man who once navigated the corridors of fear, but has now emerged as the shining star of our school.
Hold your applause for the head boy, a true testament to resilience and growth. As he takes the center stage, witness the transformation from a timid soul to the charismatic leader,
who now commands the spotlight with grace and confidence. We now invite our head boy, Arjun Sharan Devanan, onto the stage.
Good evening, esteemed headmaster, deputy headmaster, Jojo sir, respected teachers, fellow Laurentians, and for one last time, the cherished group of friends who've also become my second family, the remarkable batch of 24. Before I begin, can we just take a moment to soak in the legacy of 165 years, the vast beauty of 750 acres, the camaraderie of 850 present souls, and the storied history of all its alumni. Now, you know, when it comes to Lawrence, what's the real deal? Is it Lovedale, the place? Is it the diverse faces shaping our daily narrative? Or perhaps the resonance of shared emotions in these echoing halls? I think it's an intangible thread binding us through thick and thin, or the contagious passion we carry everywhere we go. Or maybe, just maybe, is the comforting familiarity of home, or just the enduring bond we've crafted within the timeless embrace of these historic bricks and walls. Ladies and gentlemen, that profound connection, that culmination of 165 years of collective tales is what we formally, yet affectionately, call Laurentia. You know, the farewell assembly is today. Can you believe it? An entire grade is passing. You know, I can't imagine what that's like. Year after year, we watched our seniors receive their scarves and blazers, deliver these very speeches, hug their juniors and friends, and step out of that large hall aisle for the last time. But look around. We are going to receive those scarves and blazers. Our friends are sitting here. The boards all around say class of 2024. This moment is ours. You know, wasn't it just like 5 minutes ago we were waiting for a long-awaited batch hoodies, wondering when grade 11 would step into our joints? You know, we've played memorable truth or dares during our OBL trips. We fought with each other in every possible corner in junior school, received our memorable nicknames from SD sir, had Wi-Fi issues during online classes, and always, as usual, fulfill the rite of passage that is always being late for English class. From dreaming to what senior school would look like, to realizing there is no school above to discover. From the first time we met each other in prep school, to the first time we fought in junior school. From the first time we sang the old school song a decade back, to the last one that we will sing here today. From scribbling on our hands to receiving our graduation certificates, today we walked into a beloved large hall as students of the Lawrence School Lovedale, and we're going to walk out as alumni. Rao sir, it is your vision that has shaped this institution into the one that is so dear to us, that we are torn between our desires to stay here forever and take flight into the world. It is here that we form the strongest of friendships, loved together, cried together, laughed together, and lost together. It is here we've equipped with the skills of empathy, honesty, compassion, resilience, and determination sure to carry us far in life. Next, you know, I would like to thank our beloved teachers who taught us to spell our names correctly, then stood by us as we found our identities. We so often take for granted the time that we had. and underestimated the impact you've had on us. It is now that I'm growing aware of how instrumental my prep school and junior school teachers were in inculcating in me the values integral to my principles today. How can I forget the senior school teachers who nudged me towards finding my passions and braced me towards entering the outside world? You allowed us to fall down and scrape our knees and ensured you were there to help us get back up stronger. From holding us tightly for our shortcomings in classes to finally letting go of us today, we will never forget you or stop being grateful to you for the indelible mark you've left on us. To the support staff, coaches, security, medical team, Annas, Akkas, IT, catering team, and transport staff, thank you for smiling and greeting us every time you saw us. Your wishes of good luck before every exam made all the difference. You've taught us the kind of human beings we should be. You make it possible for the school to be what it is. To our parents and every loved one who's been pivotal to our journey, regardless of whether they're present here or not, thank you for making sacrifices for us with smiles on your faces. We will never be fully able to express the immense gratitude we have towards you. We may be starting a new chapter in life. We may be growing up, but we will always need you. As we batchmates part ways with the board exams, we simultaneously break down in each other's arms, swearing to never let go of one another. That is the beauty of the paradox we face today. You know, it doesn't matter whether you've spent 9, 6, 4, or 2 years together. How do we say goodbye to the home that's fundamentally made us who we are? To the place that forms the first line of introduction for ourselves? To our childhood? Will our bonds remain strong? Are we ready? But simultaneously, coexisting with all our insecurities, with all our fears, all the uncertainties, and all the unanswerable questions, the following remains resolutely true for each one of us. It is time. We need to move forward. We are ready. What felt like struggling to hold on to memories slipping through our fingers feels different now. We are not losing our bonds. We are not losing our home. We are not losing our family. We're simply making room for our lives to intersect with those of more people, to find more places to call home that one day will grow as special to us as this one. It's scary, yes, but so was walking into the school for the first time. In this moment, think about your favorite moments here in school. Perhaps a friend you can't imagine your life without. A passion that shaped who you are. A piece of advice someone gave you. An argument that changed you for the better. Keep those people, those defining moments close to you. We may be in different parts of the world, but those moments are ours to treasure forever. Now, before I conclude, I would like to narrate to you a short story about fear. You know, in the corridors of junior school, fear gripped me tightly. Fear of judgment, fear of trying, fear to even speak. You know, I was once called upon in my class of 30 people and was asked to read a text. And I broke down in front of the class and I couldn't utter a word. But those moments, etched in fear, sculpted the resilient soul standing before you today. I've known failure intimately, countless times. If you felt shattered, alone, depressed, I have to walk those paths. Imagine a boy who once stammered, you know, he's now standing here speaking effortlessly. It's a testament to the transformative power of embracing failure. If you're at the brink of drowning in doubt, remember this, failure isn't your final chapter. It's the first step towards your dreams. I stand as a living proof that broken can mend, silenced can find their voice. Believe with every fiber of your being that your struggles are the raw materials for your triumph. Class of 2024, being a part of the 120 unforgettable people that formed this family has been an honor of a lifetime. The unity that characterizes our batch is truly moving. Be it collectively bunking classes or jointly celebrating every achievement of our batchmates. It will be difficult to adjust to a life where we don't see each other every day, where our best friends aren't right across the social area. But it's the unity of a batch that has shown through thick and thin that makes me confident. No matter where we are, no matter where we achieve, where we go, we will always have each other to come back to. Sarthak and Harshit, this is your sign to start planning our first reunion. Within this large hall, I see people who have the drive and power to change the world. Every single person here, be it senior, junior, staff, support staff, regardless, is an inspiration. I cannot wait to watch you conquer the world. So, for the last time, class of 2024, as we step out of the familiar large hall aisle for the first time today as alumni of the Lawrence School of Law, ask yourself, what could I be? Are we ready?
Thank you so much, Arjun, for those inspiring and thought-provoking words. And thank you for sharing with us your story of how Lawrence School helped you grow as a person and for always motivating us to follow our dreams. And now, for the most awaited part of the farewell, the presentation of the mementos and school colors.
And of course, the fun snippets that come along with it. Nirupama, the stage is yours.
Thank you, Aryan and Gopika. I would like to invite Jijo sir to present the mementos to the following students. The equestrian maestro effortlessly commands the reins as the charismatic captain of the horse riding team. Put your hands together for Aryan Chauhan, awarded colors in equestrian for his achievements. He is a joyous spirit without compare, sees the world through his lens, clicks every picture with flair, makes everyone laugh with jokes so clever, the day doesn't end without his famous one-liners. Here comes Ashray Mittal. He is a constant joker, spreads laughter like an all-star, albeit while cheering fervently for CSK from afar. Here comes Abhivir, awarded scarf in cricket for his achievement. He is the cricket whiz, the classroom topper. Watches too many reels, he is an Instagram hopper. Known for acing BST tests and also for his Gandhi specs. He is a city fanatic. His whacks are cinematic. His knowledge for football, scholastic. He is a gentleman with fine aesthetic. Here comes Ajendra, awarded colors in hockey. Thank you, Jijo sir. Now, I would like to invite to stage BDK ma'am to felicitate the following students. With her unwavering support, we can conquer it all. for she is the one who catches us when we fall. Here comes Akshita, awarded colors in basketball and hockey. She dribbles the ball with grace. With pink shoes, she sets the pace. Anaya Dhar is her name. Don't fall for her smile. With her, she has been awarded a blazer in basketball and hockey for her achievements. Life is just a little brighter when he's around. That's Anston, the funny and playful guy who effortlessly keeps everyone entertained. Our head boy, the man who leads the school like a boss, but also casts spells for Tottenham to win. Let's welcome Arjun Sharandev to stage. He has been awarded a scarf in cricket. Man dances better than Hrithik Roshan. Wants to go to Harvard. Math is his passion. Well, Aryaman, I don't know about your Harvard dream. He has been awarded a scarf in hockey and in football for his achievements. Thank you, ma'am. Over to Anna.
Thank you, Nirupama. Now I invite Preston ma'am to felicitate the following students. The seventh sensation known as the Big Daddy of Raipur talks with no hesitation. On the court, his skills shine bright. There's no accounts problem he can't get right. Here is Aryan Kedia being awarded a scarf in basketball for his achievements. Her glass skin is the epitome of perfection. Lauren School's very own avatar will mesmerize you from within. Here comes Harshini. Her voice is strong. Her vision is clear. Dia's leadership fills others with cheer. She leads the dance and the parade, a leader in every role portrayed. With each step, a legacy is laid. Meenakshi, her embrace so kind, motherly love a treasure to find. Vikram, the living legend boasting a chest bigger than life, earning the title of GOAT in every way possible. Awarded color in badminton for his achievements. Thank you, Preston ma'am. Now I invite Sherpal sir to present the mementos. A Man United fanatic on the couch, a wannabe Ronaldo on the pitch. His passion scores higher than his actual goals. Here is Devia being awarded color in hockey and in football for his achievements. Krishnam Kanodia, this TV captain rules over screens like they are his loyal subjects. Mastering the art of entertainment with his remote. Kunal rocks business books. Defends like a champ. Cheers for United with every goal and lamp. He is awarded color in football for his achievements. Lakshana, with kindness as your guide, equestrian captain in warmth takes pride. Anish, the bedhead extraordinaire, rules the school with the finesse of a sultan. His secret? Probably more naps than strategy meetings. Akhil is like the chilled out cousin of Thomas Shelby, gliding through life without a worry in the world, making his own path as he pleases. Now, over to Agastya.
Thank you, Anna. Quiet and sweet, Meenakshi's words are a treat, guiding with grace, advice discreet. Football's grace, she plays the part. Punjabi beats, they echo in Niha's heart. Thank you, Sherpal, sir. Now, I call upon Sisodia, sir, to felicitate the following students. Nitin, a stylish defender, channels the charm of Vijay, mastering the field with flair and his ferocious tackles. Awarded colors in football and a blazer in athletics for his achievement. With her ukulele and caring personality, Niharika uplifts spirits, creating harmony. Awarded colors in basketball and a blazer in hockey for her achievements. Shriyan, the guy who loves music so much that even his alarm clock is probably jealous of the attention he gives to his favorite tunes. Singing on stage, tackling on the field. Don't forget, Santra is the dancing queen. Awarded color in hockey for her achievements. Our school's very own Usain Bolt. Nanjappa breaks records more frequently than Ronaldo and Messi. He blazes through his opponents, leaving them a few light years behind. Awarded blazer in athletics for his achievement. The Desi Dynamo, embracing everything Indian like it's his personal superhero cape. Well, I guess you can say Path is the Desi version of Shakespeare's hero. A personality so loud and confident, Pramita's perseverance is godsend. Pranav is a tech and cricket buff. In nets and codes, he's more than enough. Laughs all around, this guy's tough. Awarded scarf in hockey and in cricket for his achievement. An all-rounder, to say the least, enthusiasm that none can defeat. Proudly commanding the best guard, she's a role model, constantly working hard. She's headstrong and knows her way around people. Priya's diligence paired with perfection is her weapon, lethal. Awarded colors in hockey and a blazer in basketball for her team. The cricket star on the field, and a comedy champ off it. Whether he's taking wickets or cracking jokes, Rishi's always a hit. Awarded colors in cricket for his achievements. Thank you, Sisodia, sir. Now over to Aryan.
Thank you, Agastya. Now, I would like to invite Sial's mom onto the stage to give away the following mementos. In curls that dance, Pragalya's flair, sassy spirit is beyond compare. She has been awarded colors in hockey for her achievements. A stellar prefect, a hockey ace, a leader bold with passion and grace. Juniors follow his tune. Well, Sarthak, why are you leaving so soon? He has been awarded Blazer in hockey for his achievements. Shivank, who dreams and enough coolness to freeze the run on the courts, so dope, the basketball bounces to his beat. He has been awarded scarf in basketball for his achievement. Shrey tops accounts. Codes Python with ease, and on the basketball court, he is scoring breeze. Awarded scarf in basketball for his achievements. Senior school's big bro by day, and Lovedale's hero by night. Our multitasking Shrutik is always ready to crack a boundary. He has been awarded scarf in hockey and cricket for his achievements. With Gucci glasses and a heart so kind, Tia leaves a lasting impression in everyone's mind. She has been awarded colors in basketball for her achievement. Thank you, ma'am. I would like to invite SD sir to the stage to present the following memento. The guy who dribbles through defenders and life with equal finesse. He does it all while rocking the Malayali Cheta swag. A remarkable friend to remember, everybody. You guessed it right. Let's get Tyagi on the stage tonight. He has been awarded colors in football for his achievements. A girl with a heart so bright, Pavina's beautiful spirit takes flight. She has been awarded a scarf in athletics for her achievements. His role on the pitch is pivotal, leaving opponents inescapable. Sanjit rides through his accounts like a smooth criminal. He is not less than a godsend miracle. He has been awarded Blazer in hockey and in football, colors in athletics for his achievements. In vrudhi strokes, the waters weave, a swimmer's grace in every heave. She has been awarded colors in hockey and scarf in swimming for her achievements. Zamin, the proud Malayali mischief maker, finds joy in expertly teasing footballers, adding dash to mischievous fun to the game. Awarded scarf in cricket and football for his achievements. Thank you, sir. Over to Hiranya.
Thank you, Aryan. Now, I would like to call upon Miss Josephine to felicitate the students. Arushi, where science and chemistry align, swift melodies in her heart entwine. The guy who can explain quantum physics and then score a hat trick, making science and hockey seem like a slapstick comedy duo. Here comes Abhimanyu. He's awarded Blazer in hockey for his achievements. Curly haired with an artistic glow, K-pop rhythms through her veins they flow. Here comes Adija. She's been awarded colors in hockey for her achievements. A girl with a bow, an archer so grand, her skills in archery truly command. Here comes Aishmika. She's been awarded Blazer in archery for her skills. Amok, the human energizer bunny, is in more places than a Wi-Fi doing more things. Why are you leaving so soon? You're the one we want. He's been awarded scarf in hockey for his achievements. Thank you, ma'am. Now, I would like to call upon Rachit sir to present the mementos. Our wise head boy, leading with dazzling leadership and flair so funny, it's like his life's a sitcom. And when he's not cracking jokes, he's acting roles on stage, our school's own one-man show. Here comes Arjun. He's been awarded scarf in basketball and in swimming for his achievements. Her blazer boasts two gleaming badges. On the court, she'll without doubt win all matches. Here comes Asmi. She's been awarded scarf in badminton for her achievements. Zidane of the football field and Captain Cool on the cricket pitch. His shots and marks are as fine as him. Here comes Ayush. He's been awarded colors in hockey and cricket for his achievements. He is short in stature but high in grades, with a knack for acting and fitness. He has reached high levels in every field. Here comes Vishesh. Charming the ball and charming us all with his disarming smile. Here comes Dhananjay. He's been awarded scarf in hockey and colors in football for his achievements. Thank you, sir. I would now like to hand over the stage to Karen.
Thank you, Hiranya. Now I invite Ajia sir to present the mementos. The silent joker off the field, but on the cricket pitch, he spins with magic, getting wickets every time he makes a joke. We call upon Gautam, who is being awarded scarf in cricket in his achievements. Be it squash balls or gym weights, Harshit is ready to smash through any apex with a trending Punjabi hit. We call upon Harshit Chiranya for being awarded colors in squash for his achievements. If you need her, she's there 24/7. If you see her smile, you'll feel like she's descended from heaven. Let's give it up for Janath for being awarded scarf and tennis for her achievements. The badminton maestro who gracefully dominates the court, his gentle demeanor and wicked badminton skills make him not just a good player, but even a better friend. We welcome John Jacob Philip for getting a placer in badminton for his achievements. In band, with power she reigns, and on the keys, melody she weaves. In drama script, her heart retrieves. We welcome Jyoti for being awarded colors in hockey for her achievement. The techno wizard engineer by day, ethical hacker by night, making technology fail. We welcome Akhil on stage. When tennis strokes, a game she aims to win. Her funny spirit laughs with a grin. Please welcome Mithunya M for being awarded scarf in tennis for her achievements. Excels in computer science and stands out as a sharp observer by spotting details others might miss. We call upon Prajesh Praveen Raja for being awarded scarf in football for his achievements. The hoop maestro leading the charge in LSL's basketball court seamlessly juggles, slams, dunks with scientific equations. As a PCMB scholar, we welcome Rahul Joseph for being awarded Blazer in basketball for his achievements. Thank you, sir. I now invite Sharma sir to felicitate the mementos. The superhero of Vindhya House, swooping in to save the day for his boys with a leadership style that's a mix of peace of mind and wisdom. He turns every trouble into a solution. Let's welcome Ritesh on stage for being awarded scarf in basketball for his achievements. He's got spirit like Andrew Tate, and running long distance is his trait. Let's welcome Preetham on stage for being awarded Blazer in athletics and colors in football for his achievements. In science's realm, her love takes flight. The silent curiosity of her beams bright. Let's give it up for Sai Challa. Marvel's Gwen, a web-spinning delight. Nilgiri Sarayu is our very own pride. Shivanth, the continuous record breaker in high jump. He defends and heads with might, and his heart belongs to Real Madrid's white. He is being awarded colors in athletics and football for his achievements. Thank you, sir. Over to Sri Parvati.
Thank you, Karen. Now I invite CA ma'am onto the stage to present the mementos to the following students.
Siddharth, the human jukebox at every party, turning conversations into karaoke sessions and making friends with his own melodies. Faster than the
microwaves heat popcorn. He is awarded Blazer in hockey for his achievements. In her eyes, the stars gleam with delight, a love for ISRO, shining ever so bright. In MUN, she reigns her command, a great friend who shall never be forgotten. It's our dear Swastika. Tarun's love for badminton is so strong that he defeated the best of the best, proving his powers in swift, unexpected victories. Tarun is awarded Blazer in badminton for his achievements. He is a silent force with muscles in tune, loves anime. That is Shivram for us. Shivram Bala is awarded scarf in football for his achievements. In shy giggles, sweetness takes the lead. She provides love and care, making hearts stampede. Akanksha Srivastav is awarded scarf in badminton for her achievements. With a twinkle in her eye, she plays any role, her personality and character as vibrant as it can be. Aishi Dio is awarded color in hockey for her achievements. The way her gorgeous hair swings matches the strumming of her guitar strings, just as the beautiful melodious songs she sings. Aadi is awarded Blazer in archery for her achievements. Amma's curls, a radiant embrace. Lawrence Corrado echoes her grace. On stage, a great actor with flair. Here's Amma Panu. Thank you, CA ma'am. Over to Kabinadri.
Thank you, Sri Parvati. I would like to call upon SNG ma'am to present the mementos. He's armed and dangerous, his humor cancerous, his love for Arsenal vigorous. Kashish is irreplaceable. He's being awarded with a scarf in basketball for his achievements. Bhumika, a girl with a heart so pure. Her singing and caring nature, a treasure to endure. The fitness freak, goalkeeping dynamo, loves and fun wherever he'll go. Always with a trick up his sleeve, that's our Steve. Into 10 to the power 8 is the speed of light. Before that, she is out of sight. Let's call upon Gauri. The gym guru and a standout senior, effortlessly lifting weights and guiding others with expertise. That's Hariaksha Reddy. Thank you, ma'am. Next, I would like to invite Divyanka ma'am onto the stage. In the realms of intellect, she takes her part. A quiz maestro, debating with art. That's Jiaman. A Habibi who's got time, whether it be to defend on the front lines or refine his fashion style. Joel's always the tagline. A smile stronger than the sun's beams. And charisma so enchanting. Krishna's words ignites and inspires everyone. Mishka in her headband chic, in Taylor Swift her heart does speak. Rocks the hockey goal and has killer fashion sense. Living with him is like having a stylish goalie in the squad. That's Aniket for us. Thank you, Divyanka ma'am. I would like to call upon Ronak to continue the proceedings.
Thank you, Kamalini. Now I would like to call upon Purna sir to give out the following memento. The man who loves Lawrence as much as his chicken biryani. He left and joined back in 11th just to have a taste of his favorite meal. Let's welcome Nagul on the stage. In her loving nature, compassion brightly gleams. A girl who loves to sleep yet helps fulfill dreams. Let's call upon Nakshatra. She has been awarded a scarf in swimming for her achievements. With shiny crystals on her side, her height is her pride. Here comes Niharika, awarded blazer in hockey for her achievements. Rishabh is a man who loves to stay in his own world and explore more anime while simultaneously becoming better in badminton. Soumya, with sass and palette in her hand, paints the day. Eyes so pretty, they light her way. Thank you, Purna sir. Now I would like to call upon Arnab sir to come on the stage and give the following meme. Is she sarcastic or silly? It's hard to tell. But her laughter is contagious, casting a spell. Here comes Shruti, awarded color in hockey for her achievements. Tikshna Vindhya's prefect commands Lauren's spirit in her capable hands. Awarded color in hockey for her achievements. In the saddle's embrace, Kayana finds pure delight. She knows a reader's dream and a rider's might. Awarded color in hockey for her achievements. The man who pumps more iron than a steel industry. Vishal is a walking work of melodious and charming art. Awarded scarf in basketball for his achievements. Tatararantantan. Here comes Vivan Menon. The music into his ass, who sings fine like wine and is found on Futta Field more than on the band room. Awarded blazer in hockey for his achievements. Thank you, Arnab sir. Now I would like to call upon Gopika and Aryan.
Thank you, Ronak. Mr. Joseph Matthew, batch of 1974, our lovely house was once the football captain of our school. Later, he qualified as a doctor of medicine and was working in Cornwall, England when he passed away in 2014. His family, many of whom are OLs, instituted the Joseph Matthew Memorial Trophy for the best football player of the year.
And now, the moment you've all waited for, to announce and present the most awaited award, or as we Laurentians call it, the mini Ballon d'Or. We now call upon Mr. Joseph John, or Jojo sir to all of us, to come on stage and announce the best footballer of the year and to say a few words.
Exactly 50 years after he passed, he was captain of the school football team. In memory of Joseph Matthew, Arvali 1974, I'm pleased to call on stage the winner of the best football player class of 2024, Mr. V.K. Sanjeet Kumar.
And congratulations to Sanjeet on winning the award.
Now, we would like to share a video made by us, the batch of 2035.
The class of 2024 is the first batch of class 12, that I mean outgoing class 12 for me. The day I joined, I remember the first evening, all the boys of senior school wearing proper uniform for the dining hall. I compliment the head boy, vice head boy, all the prefects and all the students for doing that. All of us should remember that as long as we are in school, we wear a uniform. And once our school is over, we go to colleges, there may be a uniform, there may not be a uniform. We should be proud on wearing the school uniform till the last day. And for this, I compliment all the boys of senior school, particularly class 12. And they have done a lot of work, including, you know, the English play, the way they were conducted, the practice and all. It was really fabulous. They have done a lot of work in last 4 months. I wish they continue the good work, the new badges. And talking about girls, and they have always been very obedient as usual, you know. So, I have no complaints against anybody. I'm quite happy with the changes they have brought forward in the school. And I expect that each time, with each passing batch, things should get better and better. Basically, I need boys and girls to be very professional in their approach, even at the school level. And that will make a lot of difference for the school. Thank you.
Good evening, boys and girls. Batch of 2024, you've been a great batch. We will always remember very fondly all the contributions that you have made to the school. You're a bunch of very, very talented youngsters. You're at a very crucial stage in your career and in your life. We wish you all the best for your upcoming board exams, your college admissions, and for everything else that you are going to be doing in your life. All the best, batch of 2024.
I'm getting old and I need something to rely on. So
Enjoyed the video. I now invite our headmaster to address the gathering.
Good evening, one and all. Mr. Rajan, dear friend, Mr. Jojo, members of the staff, dear students and batch of class 12, I shall speak my mind. This morning, after the Republic Day celebrations, the vice head boy and vice head girl were called, and I wanted to know all the names so that I can speak something about everybody. But then later I understood that it's all being there. So I shall touch on some of the points which are very, very necessary. Dear students of, or I mean the class of 24, I know all of you are in cloud nine this day. I anticipated this day much, much before. All that I did is to club the Republic Day and this day such that I save one day for you. I'm sure this day is so nostalgic that none of you must have open your books to read. Am I right? If anybody has done something, that's wonderful. If anybody has done math, then I love it. It's okay. Please be quiet. I was watching one of the New Year celebrations on 31st December, and that was about Johnny Walker. The compere there was asked, "Sir, you are a very good comedian even today. Why don't you do that? Why don't you continue?" Please remember the reply. He said, "When people climb Mount Everest, they put their flag there and again come down. I have done that in my life, so I need not do that again." This is a bit different from what I'm going to tell you right now. Today, on this particular day, on a farewell assembly day, every batch of class 12 is on a high. But we are all terrestrial. We should be on ground. That's the reason I want to say something to make you serious about yourself. And that's very important. few days from now, wherever you reach, you will be at the bottom. It's a reality. From there, again you have to climb top. And this is, of course, an internal facilitation or whatever you call it. You know, a kind of reward or something. It's a good feeling. It's a lot of memories. But then, in years to come, as you grow, you should get more and more such awards. And for that, we need to work hard. When the whole world is focusing elsewhere, or the world is focusing at you, you just focus on yourself. Only then you can win. If you look here and there, if you focus elsewhere, or if you focus on what somebody else is doing, you are just wasting your time. Do not think about anything or anybody too much. I shall tell you what happens then. You like something too much, or you hate something too much. That gets into your mind, and that particular thing or object or whatever it be becomes your master. And you become its slave. So never allow anything to get into your head and make them your boss. I'm telling you, life is too short. You have very less time. You have very less time. And spend all that time that you have with you for yourself. It doesn't mean that you will not play. That is also something that you're doing for yourself. It doesn't mean that you won't make friends. If you're making friends, that is also for yourself. Okay? But when I'm saying that you need to focus on yourself, it means, when it means business, it's business, serious business. If you are successful, people will talk good about you. If you're not successful, people just won't bother to look at you. If you remember, on the farewell lunch of OIL Induction Day, I told you I want to see the next generation also studying in the school. What does that mean? In years to come, the new generations from you also should come here. That means you should be successful first. But do not always run just after success. Try to be happy. Try to be happy. That is the ultimate thing that we look for in our lives. And if you don't think of happiness, you have not lived a life. Live your life. I give you an example of a techie who was a topper in IIT and he got the best of package in US. Due to COVID, there was some breakdown and somehow he did not manage to get a job for some time. Of course, with his qualification and experience, he would definitely get a job. But then, he got frustrated and he ended his life. He could have just waited for some time and definitely would have got another job because he is so skillful. Why did that happen? He was only, you know, looking at certificates. He was only looking at getting some job or do something for himself, but then he never lived his life. Dear students, recently I read an article. It said that people die rich, but they live very poor. Anybody for that matter, whoever lives on this earth for 60 years or 50 years, whatever it be, by then he must have earned enough money for himself. He must have bought a lot of property. He must have had a lot of bank balance, everything. He is dying rich, but he is living a very poor life. Dear students, I want you to live a good life. Okay? anything that you do during the day, find some time for yourself to just be happy and do something that you like. Please do that. Please do that. Nobody does that. Nobody does that. Everybody is occupied about something. Yeah, today I have to do this, I will do it. He keeps on doing. They even lose themselves. What's the point if you're not enjoying yourself? What's the point if you're not thinking about yourself for some time? Think about your dear ones. Think about your friends. Do something every day, just few moments. Let it be a few seconds or a few minutes or anything. Please do something for yourself where you did something and you feel good. That's very important. You may be successful today. You may not be successful today. Take, for instance, any batch that has passed out of the school 10 years ago, 20 years ago, 30 years ago. They may not be toppers during that time, but everybody is doing well. Tell me one person who is jobless. Tell me one person who is jobless. Everybody is doing something, right? Somebody must have become a doctor, somebody engineer, somebody something. But everybody is doing something. There is no one in this world who is not going to do anything and sit just idle like that. All will earn. All will get married. All will get children. Everything will happen. Everything is going to happen. Nothing, nobody loses out of anything. But it all depends upon how you did it. Right? Now, from cloud nine, all that I wanted to say is to come down. Have a nice dinner. Sleep for today. Get back to work. I am coming to you with the mark sheet of trial 2. Right? Okay. And the new admissions are all going on. We are all a bit busy, but we will find some time to teach you. I'll get back to classroom. We will teach you. All of you have to get back to your books. Have a nice dinner. See you again tomorrow with mark sheet. Thank you so much. All the best.
Thank you, sir. Remember, this farewell, it's not just a goodbye. It's a commencement, a new beginning. The experiences you have had, the lessons you have learned, and the bonds you have formed, they are the stepping stones towards success and life.
Dear batch of 24, you are not just leaving the school. You are stepping into a world of endless possibilities. Go forth, spread your wings, and soar to new heights.
As you embark on this new adventure, carry the spirit of never giving with you. All of you will forever remain a cherished part of a legacy.
Wishing you all the success, joy, and fulfillment that life has to offer.
Farewell, and may your life and journey be just as extraordinary as each one of you. With heartfelt emotions, batch of 25.